Hey, Adam here, and welcome back. We're going to be exploring a disappearance today that I thought was very odd, and I'd be surprised if you've heard about this one. If you're looking for a disappearance that you can analyse and conclude that clearly not everything is known here, this seems to be one of those disappearances. If you want to sink your teeth into one of these missing person cases that is just completely odd, there's the disappearance of Guy Pope or David Horsey and Frederick Hardesty, and this is another one that I would add to that list. I'll leave links in the description pointing to those videos, and I'd like to thank GermanWolf92 for making me aware of this incident. This disappearance takes us to France, specifically the Herisson waterfalls area around 3 miles away from the town of Les Frasnois. Lucas Renoud was 20 years old when this happened in June of 2019. On the 18th of June, Lucas, along with a small group of around 8 people, went for a hike in the Herisson waterfalls area, and unlike the rest of the group, Lucas never returned to his car. Among this group of hikers were some guides familiar with the area, and at 8 p.m. that night, they were the ones that realised Lucas had vanished. Just on this particular area actually, it's a very popular tourist area, it's considered very safe, and I couldn't find mention of anyone else who'd managed to go missing here. As said, Lucas was noticed missing at about 8 p.m, and the group conducted their own initial search for him, and they were surprised that they couldn't find him. It reads to me as though they thought that they were going to find him fairly easily, and after the first couple of hours passed, they began to panic. They spent one final hour trying to retrieve him, but they saw no indication of his presence anywhere, and they then called the authorities at 11 p.m, where the official search began at 4 a.m. that morning. Now, I say things like this a fair bit, but in my opinion, 3 hours is a little too long to spend looking for a person like this, and this isn't exactly a criticism. Our normalcy bias in instances like this is probably saying, no, this can't be happening, I'm sure we'll find him any moment. And then an hour of searching has turned into 3. Just for those that haven't heard of that before, normalcy bias is just a cognitive bias which leads people to minimise warning signs in favour of, you know, everything is normally okay, therefore it's going to be okay now, thus reducing the initiative of what actually needs to happen. The official search at 4 a.m. also failed to find any clues of Lucas's presence. They were hoping to find footprints, indentations in the ground, or just something to show that someone had been there, but they didn't. The K9 Search Association came to help search for Lucas, but despite having a number of dogs throughout the area, they too were of no help. A helicopter flew over the area on Wednesday to no avail. Several soldiers from various companies and the Mosin Mountain Platoon were mobilised on Wednesday. A helicopter from the aerial section of Dijon Gendarmerie flew over the site all day in vain. It's difficult to imagine what might have happened here, but for some reason, clearly at some point in the hike, Lucas must have separated and left the group for some reason. But why? He started lagging behind and then lost them? Did something else grab his attention? He went to investigate and then lost them? There's obviously no real way of knowing for sure, but there doesn't seem to be any evidence present of this being intentional or there being a third party involvement. In any case, when the searches kept failing, the K9 Search Dog Association expanded their presence and scope. This was coupled by the military too, who now had around 40 soldiers scouring the forest areas. "The search continues, we will not let go," said Laurent Maugin, the commander of the St. Cloud Gendarmerie Company. We actually get some mention of the moment of separation. Lucas disappeared Tuesday evening during a walk on the site of Herisson Waterfalls. He walked with friends and trainees at the Frasnois Polar Park. Lucas was also a trainee. He was separated from the group about 3/4 of the way up from the bottom of the site as the young people returned to their vehicles parked in the parking lot of the Forge in Bonlau. That still doesn't quite explain precisely what had happened, but unless you fall behind for some reason and then just lose everybody, I'm not sure what else makes sense. You'd like to think that people can't just vanish from the face of the earth. Unfortunately, this Saturday, June 22, the efforts of the Gendarmes did not give more results than the previous days. "We have further extended the searches to all where it is assumed he disappeared. The Mountain Gendarmerie Platoon explored all the steep places, all the crevices, all the places inaccessible by the usual means. Since Tuesday evening, 90 gendarmes have been mobilised for these investigations. The Lons dog team has come twice. St. Hubert from the Metz Dog Intervention Group also intervened. The helicopter carried out two overflights. One with a thermal camera, said the company commander. I haven't actually mentioned this yet, but the gendarmes is a military force with law enforcement duties too, a paramilitary group. So this was clearly a search that was growing in intensity. Some commenters made the point that they couldn't believe that he hadn't been located given all of the resources that had been poured into the search effort. I think a lot of people were being left dumbfounded here, leading the authorities to say that they aren't ruling out any leads, and some papers, including this one, started to pose a few questions. Lucas never returned from his walk. A week later, the efforts to try to find him were in vain. The investigators announced the end of the search. Was he the victim of an accident? Did he flee? Was he taken by someone? The issue in my mind is that if an accident had taken place here, given the intensity and the scale of the search, you'd really like to think they would have found him. However, and granted, I am aware that there are many complexities that we can't fully appreciate sitting here at our keyboards. Other accidents, such as animal predation, typically leave obvious signs, you know, that's not exactly a clean affair. Normally, evidence of something like that would have been expected to be left behind. Was he taken by a third party? The problem here is that there were 8 other people present, and they never heard any signs of this. There was no shouting, screams, and no audible signs of a struggle. To clarify, actually, there were no signs of a struggle full stop. So what happened to him then? I suppose you could make the case that he must have left intentionally. The problem with that is you normally find evidence of that too. This is normally in texts, emails, search history, etc. But as far as I could tell, there was nothing suspicious like that. It's also understandable why the search came to an end at that time too. Despite the efforts involved, if they couldn't look at any trace of him at all, there may have been some private opinions and conversations questioning if he was even in the area anymore. We have to get bizarre now too, because all of those potential suspicions and thoughts were wrong. And Lucas's body was found on the 26th of June, 2019. A body was indeed found at the beginning of the afternoon, 30 metres from a path a little away from the sector where the young man was hiking. The circumstances of this disappearance are disturbing. According to his relatives, Lucas had walked with a small group of 7 to 8 people, colleagues from his internship. He would have been left behind and would have lost sight of them. The alert on his disappearance was given Tuesday at the end of the evening when his absence was noted around 11 p.m. At 10:20 p.m, Lucas called 112 emergency services and told the rescuers that he was lost in the middle of the forest and that he was tired of going back and forth because his legs were sore. I'm surprised that wasn't mentioned earlier, and this obviously means that Lucas had basically reported his own disappearance to the authorities before his companions did. So any thoughts that this was intentional can be swept aside now. I'm surprised they weren't able to locate his position in this instance, and I'll take the time to say it again. This is precisely why, if going into these wilderness areas, then please make sure you have an app like What Three Words. This helps the authorities to pinpoint your location should something like this ever happen. In any case, the authorities also did not suspect any kind of foul play, only adding that a cause of passing had not been determined. Now let's have a look at another article in which the family expresses confusion and were having a hard time understanding and explaining what had happened here. 1 month after the disappearance on June 18, 2019, Lucas's family calls out to the authorities and can no longer bear the silence surrounding his passing. His family remains inconsolable and still wonders what could have happened so that a young man of 20 met his demise in this way, by visiting one of the most banal areas possible. That translated oddly no matter how I went about it, but what the family are getting at is that they're saying that the area is easy to navigate, they're saying that it's not too taxing on the body, which is probably why it's such a popular tourist site. Ultimately, they're expressing their confusion as to how this could have happened in this location of all places. The family continues. How is it possible? What happened? He dialed 112 around 10:20 p.m. to say that he was lost. They didn't even bother to find you. How does a 20-year-old young man disappear and then pass away in a forest uninjured? How can we believe all this? I do find myself in agreement with the family's line of thought here. It's difficult to make sense of this one, and perhaps it's about to become even more difficult to make sense of. Despite Lucas calling 112, during which he explained he was lost, followed by an extensive search, his body was not found until June 26, just 30 metres from one of the site's trails, which was very busy during this period of the year. On June 26, the tragic discovery comes close to these assumptions and always arouses the incredulity of the volunteers. I do not understand how he was not found earlier. We all passed by without seeing the body. Myself, I had been within 10 meters of his final location. The next part translates oddly no matter how I go about it, but the volunteer basically states that he had a very hard time trying to understand how this happened, and that the only explanation must have been that he was well hidden by the trees. Which very well could be the case, but it's still odd that the searchers had been right on top of him and not found him. The sheer disbelief being expressed makes me think that the volunteer wasn't fully accepting of his own explanation, but of course I don't know this for sure. I get why he'd feel so unsure here. A number of articles being written by the press were posing a lot of questions about this themselves. The Le Parisien asks, how, in spite of the extensive search effort, was the body not found? They also ask, above all, when and in what manner did he pass away? These are some great questions, especially when you consider that you had searchers coming within meters of the exact spot the body was found. I'd love to know if search dogs ever frequented this area too. Unfortunately, there's no word on this, but that would provide clarity as to whether he was there or he was well hidden. It was another hiker who found the body on the 26th, and this person was just walking by randomly, so that kind of description makes you feel like it can't have been that well hidden. Or of course, there could have been other indicators at this point, such as smell. Again, just other complexities that we can't fully appreciate, but you see what I mean. There is also some other weirdness too. It has been stated firstly that Lucas was uninjured. However, the family also stated this. We weren't even allowed to see you because your body was too damaged. That's how that translates, and I'm assuming we are talking in terms of deterioration, because those conducting the autopsy said that there were no injuries present. The body, presumably, was there for 8 days, and this was in summertime too, so I imagine it was fairly hot throughout this time. I don't see how they can be talking about actual injuries given what's been said. Then after that, we get this. Logically, the preliminary investigation opened for a disturbing disappearance has been reclassified as a search for the cause of passing. An autopsy was carried out, but none of the conclusions have filtered out. The new public prosecutor, Lionel Pascal, has been arguing that additional analyses need to be carried out. However, Lucas's body was returned to the family and buried, says Mielsa Ghanasia, the family lawyer, astonished. So, the family were never allowed to see his body, and despite Lionel Pascal's protests and arguments in favour of requiring further study before a judgment could be passed, the body was buried. That kind of feels, in some sense, like we're sweeping things under the rug. The combination and sequence of events really seems questionable. I've not heard of that happening before. So a cause was never determined, and before one could be, he's already buried? Why? I'm having a hard time understanding why that was beneficial. It's difficult to make the case that it was for the family's benefit because they were determined to find answers and they were desperate to understand what had happened. There are also a variety of reasons why you would want to have a full understanding first. Firstly, for closure, not just for the family, but for the community too. This is important and it also helps with public confidence and feelings of being safe and secure in your environment. It certainly helps for educational purposes because if you find out that he had X underlying condition that caused Y and Z to happen, these have the potential to make others aware and to prevent it from happening again. It also provides the medical community a chance to weigh in and talk about things. What do you make of that? Maybe I'm just missing something obvious, but on the surface, it certainly feels like the authorities wanted this incident to be over and done with. The only thing the family was told was that they had excluded the possibility of a third party, but other than that, they say that they were given no further information. The point of also not being able to see the body was clarified too. Mourning is all the more difficult for Lucas's parents as they were unable to see their son before he was put in the coffin. His body having been too damaged by his stay of a week in the forest. The family wrote to the prosecutor a number of times who takes refuge behind the secrecy of the investigation. their second letter went unanswered. The family finds themselves alone with unanswered questions. An initial autopsy was carried out. It would reveal no trace of a blow that could have suggested third-party involvement. No obvious trace of a stroke or heart attack either. Another disturbing fact is the 112 call made by Lucas 1 hour 30 minutes after losing his friends. In the recording of the conversation, his mother was able to listen to, Lucas explains that he's lost, that his legs hurt and that he must return because he works the next day. The operator then tells him he must try to find his way back, then the call is cut off. Some of this is just plain creepy. The call cut off randomly, and as far as I can tell, there were no further attempts to make contact. He passes away for some reason, and the initial autopsy is inconclusive. Then, despite arguments being made that further analysis is required to understand what had happened, he's buried quickly. And all further information remains secretive, and the family aren't able to find anything out, nor access to the autopsy report. Weird. I hadn't mentioned this so far either, but Lucas's body was found around 500 metres away from the parking lot, and this is around 540 yards. France Blue also confirms that no apparent or significant injuries were noted on his body, and the area in question didn't allow for a fall to have taken place. The area of question was also described as an area that was easily accessible. The parents were fighting tooth and nail for answers, and I found this remark quite interesting, and it just shows how frustrated and perhaps suspicious even the family were about this whole ordeal. Lucas's mother said, "We're not being told anything. It's unbearable. We never had access to the autopsy reports. We didn't even know if it, the body I assume, was returned. We just saw the coffin. We couldn't see Lucas since apparently his body was too damaged. They brought him back to us in a coffin and we said goodbye to him like that." This might just blow your mind now. The parents of Lucas Renoud had been waiting for this meeting with the prosecutor for 5 months. But they came out on Tuesday even more tested than before. No analysis has been conclusive. We will never know how Lucas passed away. I had the impression that I was being informed for the second time on his passing. To grieve, you need explanations, but we won't have any of that. For lack of being able to specify the cause, to be considered as natural, Lionel Pascal therefore announced that he had ordered the investigation to be closed without further action. An outcome which the lawyer of the parents of the family, Mie Elsa Gassanier, did not expect at all. "With all of the current scientific investigative techniques, I do not understand why we cannot determine what the cause was." I'm not sure I've ever heard that said before, that they absolutely cannot figure it out and therefore natural causes are to be assumed. Which is fair enough though, if current scientific methods are not enough to understand, what else can you do? Normally though, a more presentable argument is given in favour of why it was of natural causes. You see this repeatedly throughout my videos. It's not normally presented as, we have no idea what happened, therefore we consider it to be X, case closed, move on. I hate to leave it like this too, but that was literally the end of the paper trail. There's no more mention of this disappearance, at least that I could find. So just to collect ourselves here, let's very briefly summarise exactly what happened. Lucas goes out with his friends and colleagues. On their way back to the parking lot, he somehow becomes separated. He calls 112 and basically reports his own disappearance. The group searches for him in disbelief for 3 hours, but couldn't find anything. A rather large search starts the following morning and is a complete failure, with searches literally a few meters away from the body, but they never saw him. The body was found 8 days later by a random hiker who was passing by. This causes confusion among the searchers who were at that very location beforehand. The authorities take the body and don't allow the family any kind of access, nor are they particularly forthcoming to the parents. Other than clarifying that he'd sustained no injuries and that there was no third party involvement. The family receive a coffin with Lucas's body inside, though at one point some family members seem to question this. He was then promptly buried, despite protests from Lionel that further tests needed to be undertaken. And then finally, no further information ever came to light. I can certainly understand why the family felt like they were being dismissed, and that the whole incident was being swept under the rug. What do you make of this disappearance? Do you think it was odd? Did Lucas just stray from the group and then was just well hidden by the trees? Do share your thoughts. I'd just like to thank you for watching. If you found the video interesting, then please do remember to subscribe, hit the like button and notification bell on your way out. If not, then feel free to give it a thumbs down. I'm just looking for your honest opinion, either way. I hope that you've had a great day or evening, depending on where you are, and I'll see you in the next one. Be safe, guys. Peace.